You gotta tell her, man, you know. So we're in bed one night, and I'm spooning, we're spooning, you know, she's knocked out, she's off to sleep. I figure this is my chance to, you know, touch her, fill up, you know, just fill her, you know, try to fill on her, I'm getting close to her, I got my bag over her, doing that whole, you know what I'm talking about, we're all doing that. It takes a little longer, my age, it takes a little longer to get a boner, so you gotta really work it, she's in mind. I should eat that burrito today. That is your cheese. Gotta stop doing that shit. It's gotta be the problem. I can't get it up anymore. I'm getting there. Feels good. All of a sudden, what the fuck? That shit vibrated so much I came out of her back. Like, oh my god, you thought I'd be happy. I wasn't happy. It was an angry come. I didn't see it coming. Wipe that shit up. Forget about it. Put it on the shower rod. Next morning, you take the shower. Pull that thing off. Start crying yourself. For some reason, the crusty part always hits the face. Watch out for crusty towels! Watch out for crusty towels! You know, and you know, love is love. When you're in that love that long, I've been married over 28 years. Battles, farting and shit. But anyways, alright, you know, we love each other, but we're at that point. Fucking taking a shit. Hey girl, I forgot to get the toilet paper. Can you go bring me some? You should have thought about that shit before you went in there. You know, she don't give a fuck situation, but real quick, let me just tell you a real I don't give a fuck story. I was in Reno a couple of weeks ago, partying. I like to drink, I'm gonna lie. So I'm having a good time. We get home, get to the hotel at 3 o'clock in the morning, and I'm laying there, and I'm feeling like I'm having a heart attack. I'm telling you, I'm laying there, she's next to me, she's knocked out again. And then I'm going through the motions. I'm like, Bob, what's this all about? Holy shit, this is real. I think this is happening. So I hit my wife. Hey, girl, I'm having a heart attack. She goes, shut up. It's not a heart attack. Yes, it is, girl. This is the real one. She goes, it's probably heartburn. It's not heartburn. Go to the restroom. You're making too much noise. Fuck. Get out of bed. You don't give a fuck anymore. Get to the restroom. Sitting on the toilet by myself, having a heart attack. I don't want to make too much noise, I'm gonna wake up. Then I start thinking, well, what fucking sight they see when you have the pain on the right arm or the left arm? I don't know, I get up and I look in the mirror. But now I'm fucking confused, it's reversed, it's back in the day. I go outside of the room, I wake up. Yo, this shit's real. Fucking call the ambulance. All right, I'm gonna call the ambulance. Yeah. But you better not go with them, because they're gonna charge your fucking ass. You don't give a fuck. All right, just call them, please. Real. She don't call them direct. She calls the goddamn front desk to call. She wanted 10 more minutes of sleep, I don't know. So then I'm over there getting ready, waiting for them, looking out the window and waiting for an ice cream truck. I'm still over there. Finally they come out. I go out, I jump, I don't even wait for them to come. I'm feeling it, I go down there. Put that fucking gurney back in, I jump inside. All of a sudden I'm feeling it, I'm talking the whole thing, I'm like, I'm having chest pains, and my neck's hurting, and I don't know, my fucking arm is hurting, and there's my wife, he's just a crybaby, he's always complaining, I told him to come in heartburn, he's stupid, you know, and I'm like, get this fucking out of here, please, get out of here. Sir, come down, we gotta check your vitals, but you have a little too much hair on your chest, so we're gonna have to shave you a little bit. Put an EKG on you, I'm like, son of a gun. I go, no. I said, I'm sitting there, and I'm going, sitting there. I'm like, no. All right, go ahead and shave, but can you not make it look like a jack-o'-lantern face? Shit, the last time it looked like a pumpkin, and it wasn't even Halloween. I know they were laughing. All right, so don't worry about that. But as I'm laying there, instead of thinking like, oh, who's going to pay the bills when I die? And what motherfucker's going to start fucking my wife when I die? I'm thinking like, fuck, if I die right now, they're gonna find the porn that's on my phone! They're gonna know I like midget sex! Oh my god, midget sex! Oh my god. But that's my time, guys. Thank you very much.
Give it up, give it up, the talent, Ray Martinez! Woo! The show, right? Yeah, I like it. Try to follow them, and sometimes their work is so damn good, you can't fault them for that. Speaking of jobs, what's a job like in Fresno? Good, bad? Job market good or bad?
Can't even get a job out here.
I know, it's bad everywhere. I live in LA, I've been there for about 10 years, and I've had jobs here and there as a comic, you know, you struggle. I started doing Uber. Of course, I'm telling the white people that I'm doing it for comedy's sake, you know, because that's, you know, the subtle thing. Oh yeah, I'm just doing Uber part-time. Yeah, while I'm doing the comedy thing, you know, because I'm doing it for the stories. And they're like, oh, that's so funny. They're like, tell me what. I'm like, no, you were supposed to tell me a fucking story. Where am I supposed to report back? Let me tell you, how many people take Uber here?
No.
Wow.
What did you say?
What, y'all don't have credit cards in fucking Fresno? I know they don't take EBT for Uber, but shit. A debit card or something. Everybody got their own car in Fresno?
Yeah.
It's true. I would be very sketchy about taking an Uber in Fresno. You'd be pulling out a gun before they do. You'd be like, you take me to the supermarket? You take me to the goddamn supermarket. If it only costs $4. So, anyhow, are you guys ready for more comedy?
Yeah!